Hi, my name is Brian Schwartz. I'm a professor of law at the University of Manitoba in Winnipeg, Canada, and I'm one of the creators of the Mishpatim program here in 2012. This is the second year that we've operated it for Canadian students. Last year for law students, this year we have a number of commerce students as well. Last year Manitoba, this year Manitoba and Saskatchewan, tomorrow Canada, and after that the world. The answer I often give when people ask me why would you study all kinds of issues in Israel is that everything that happens in Canada that has any kind of legal dimension happens in Israel. Not only happens, it happens with an added level of complexity and intensity. So whether it's the balancing of human rights against security interests, trying to accommodate religion within a secular state, all these issues arrive in Israel. And they tend to have all kinds of complications and nuance which add to any student's understanding of the issues. So the opportunity for students to come here and compare and contrast what happens in the Israeli legal system with what happens in our own, I think students find to be a great educational value. One of the dimensions that our course has that is quite uncommon in these kinds of programs is we not only focus on human rights, we also have a major business and economic dimension to the program. The assigned reading for the students before they come here is Startup Nation, which is about the Israeli high-tech miracle, how this little country against incredible odds has become a world innovator in technology and in entrepreneurship. Then we try and combine those elements, human rights issues and business and economic issues, in various ways. So we ask questions like, okay, how do ultra-Orthodox people fit into this high-tech society? What are the challenges of integrating Ethiopian Jews into this society? So, for example, we visited an Ethiopian absorption center nearby here in Jerusalem. We had a talk from a Druze professor at Tel Aviv University. He was talking about his adventures in the Israeli army and in politics in Israel. We had a speaker yesterday who is an East Jerusalem Arab who was talking about how he's involved in programs to teach entrepreneurship to the women of East Jerusalem. So this combination of understanding how this little country has succeeded in many ways economically, what its trade relations are, with all these human rights and social integration issues, I think gives a very balanced and diverse program that students seem to really enjoy. We have classes with distinguished lecturers from all over the place in Israel with all kinds of backgrounds and perspectives. We've also done a number of field trips, so we don't just talk about what happens, for example, in universities and high tech. We went out and had a visit to Technion. Our Druze speaker spoke to us from Haifa, didn't just come to the classroom in Jerusalem. So a lot of lectures here, a lot of organized field trips, and the opportunity to experience the country in every which way. So as I say, this program is our inaugural year in terms of having commerce as well as law students, and we're hoping, looking ahead, that it'll be an annual event, an enduring part of the educational program here at Hebrew University, and one that's eventually accessible to students across Canada, maybe across North America eventually, and of interest not only to students in law, but also students business, commerce, entrepreneurship, political science, you name it.